Yeah, I started on June the 10th, and other than having the mayor comment about the budget cuts there on day one, which I hadn't expected, it's been really good. So it's been 6 months and a couple of days, and the service has been wonderful, the community has been wonderful. There's been lots of great work done. I couldn't be happier to have made the move. What we've been actually monitoring, in addition to the numbers of crimes, is the numbers of unique users at the supervised consumption site. So what we were seeing is there was actually a correlation between the numbers of unique users and calls for service and crime numbers in the area. So last I saw the stats there, we were well over 1,000. And that had gone up, I think, quite substantially through the year for people utilizing the site. I would say that the crime numbers have stabilized, but they're certainly elevated in comparison to where they've been in the past. And the numbers of calls for service, and a lot of those are kind of disorder type calls, those are still going on. We know that our presence down there with the extra beat team that's down there all the time has actually been very, very positively received by the community and the business owners down there. So we're going to continue to be there for them and work on this issue, but certainly it's a complex issue that involves multiple sectors and not just police. So we see the shootings, and the numbers of the shootings are into the 80s for us this year, which is high. Last year was a low year for us, and so I think we were into the 40s. So if we compare 1 year to the next, it looks really bad. But if we compare this year to the five-year average, it isn't as bad. But still, I would say it's completely unacceptable, the amount that we've seen. And the number of guns that our officers are taking off the streets every night, including the last couple nights again, I'm really quite concerned about it. I'm concerned for public safety, I'm concerned for officer safety, I'm concerned for all of it. And so we're in the process right now of reevaluating sort of the way we went at this in 2019 to figure out what worked for us, maybe what didn't work, and what we need to change going into 2020. And we will have a new strategy for this issue in 2020 that will see us put a strong focus on this issue. I guess what I've learned is that our workplace here is not so different than other public sector workplaces. So in this day and age, I think if you've got people, you've got a propensity to have conflict. So I think the issue is not so much whether or not you'll have it, it's how you choose to, or how you equip your workforce to deal with it. So conflict can be dealt with either constructively or destructively. And so some of the ways that conflict was being managed perhaps wasn't as positive as it could have been. So I think for us, one of the things we've looked at is our processes that we have in place. I think we have quite strong processes in the Calgary Police Service. There were some issues around, people having confidence around accessing them. And a number of times, I think people did access them and perhaps didn't get to outcomes that they thought they might. We've done some work at the front end in terms of triaging. When people come in to the system, when they have an issue, we make sure that we get them going down the right path, depending on what sort of outcome they're seeking. That's been helpful. We've had a number of opportunities actually to be more proactive about how we're dealing with conflict in the Calgary Police Service. So by that I mean we've proactively gone out in where we've had workforces or workplaces where we had concerns raised. Rather than just waiting for employees to come to us, we've gone out and done workplace assessments to talk to the employees proactively to find out what's going on. That's actually been a very helpful thing. We've had some success there. We have had some behavior that's been inappropriate in the year as well. We've had a couple of employees who've left the employ of the Calgary Police Service because of behavior. And I think that just underscores my commitment and the commitment of all of us to having a workplace that's free of harassment and is respectful. The gun crime that I've talked about already, that's going to be a priority for us in 2020 for certain. The other thing internally are the work around the culture piece doesn't stop. I think we've committed to the notion of human resource reform. That work's going to continue as well into 2020. And I also think just that piece around once we reconstitute the leadership team, and then begin to get folks focused again, around what being really clear about what the priorities are. I mean, right now there's so many things going on to occupy our attention. You know, I don't want us to be a mile wide and an inch deep. I want us to be well focused on the things that matter most to Calgarians.